Hi friends, welcome to a new episode of Vamos, a celebration of Latin America. Now you know me with my work with Culture Clash, the premier Chicano comedy group, but did you know that two-thirds of us are actually Salvadoran? Rick Salinas was born in El Salvador and he came up when he was three. And I was born in San Francisco of Salvadoran parents, and I went back when I was about 10 and lived there for about 6 years. So I have great memories of El Salvador before the Civil War. Now, El Salvador's been in the news since the 80s because of the Civil War, and now because of the migration of unaccompanied youth and the crisis in the border. Well, I wanted to make this episode to show you the history and give you the reasons behind this so-called crisis. All right, so are you ready? Are you ready? Vamos a El Salvador. El Salvador means the savior. You can't get more Catholic than that. Before that, it was called Cuscatlan by the Lenca and Pipil people, who were also Mayan. El Salvador is also known as Valley de las Hamacas because it has several active volcanoes in its tiny geography, so it always sways.
Colonized by Spain, it got its independence September 15, 1821. This is where it gets interesting. At the turn of the 20th century, El Salvador's main crop was indigo, but the ruling class figured out that coffee was more profitable, and that became the main export. The United Fruit Company made all Central American nations banana republics by extracting the natural resources and establishing dictatorships that only benefited the ruling class.
A very sad chapter in its history occurred in the 1930s with a communist uprising which resulted in a 30,000 peasant massacre called La Matanza. A series of military dictatorships kept on ruling until the people had enough. The Civil War started in 1979 and lasted 12 bloody years that cost 75,000 lives, including Archbishop Oscar Romero. Muchas gracias, Ronald Reagan, for funding the government death squads. 2 million Salvis left the country and came north during the 80s and landed in Los Angeles, the Bay Area, and the Washington, D.C. area.
These hard-working refugees went to work and neglected their war-torn children, who eventually became Chicano gang members, like 18th Street, and the crazier ones formed MS-13. The LAPD had their hands full, and instead of reforming these guys, the US government deported them back to El Salvador, while in El Salvador, they got even bigger and deadlier by recruiting underprivileged Central American youth.
This, of course, made concerned parents send their unaccompanied children up north to avoid recruitment and death. Thus, the current so-called refugee border crisis is a result of American intervention in Central America since last century. So deal with it.
Mic drop!
I was born in San Francisco in 1959. My middle name is Orlando, after Giants first baseman, Orlando Cepeda. My dad was a young middle-class adventurer and came up from El Salvador in the 1940s and landed in New York City with his cousins. They all enlisted in the Army during World War II and got their dual citizenships. My dad met my mom in a Salvi boarding house in San Francisco, and they went back to El Salvador and had my brother Ruben. They came back in the late 50s and had me. My dad took me to live in El Salvador from 1969 to 1975, and that's where I learned Spanish and saw social inequality. I came back before the Civil War and went to art college and joined the circus, Culture Clash, with Rick and Richard Montoya, aka Super Chicano Man.
I was born in San Salvador, the capital of El Salvador, and we left for the U.S. Very similar to how Europeans left for Ellis Island, for a better life. We flew on a Pan Am airplane in the mid-1960s, first landing in Los Angeles, then moving to San Francisco, where I grew up in the Mission District. My Salvi family is small. My parents, sister, and I lived in one of those classic San Francisco Victorian flats. I remember in my elementary school, none of the school kids knew what a Salvadoran was. So I would say that I was Spanish, and sometimes I would just give in and say that I was Mexican. I graduated from San Francisco State University with two BAs, one in broadcasting and the other in speech communications. My first real job out of college was at an NBC affiliate, but I quit to join the circus of Culture Clash, with the other Salvadoreño, Herbert, and super Chicano, Richard Montoya.
Did you know that Archbishop Oscar Romero, who spoke out against social injustice and violence in El Salvador, was murdered by an assassin from the military government while celebrating Mass? In 2018, he was canonized by the present Pope Francis. Romero is now a saint. This is a true story that hasn't been told. José Arturo Castellanos, a colonel from El Salvador, served as a diplomat in Geneva, Switzerland during World War II. He saved 40,000 Jews from extermination by the Nazis by providing them with Salvadoran identity documents. He was given the Righteous Among Nations honor granted to non-Jews by Yad Vashem, an institution that honors the memory of martyrs and heroes of the Holocaust. Where's Steven Spielberg when we need him to show positive Latino role models in cinema?
Worcester sauce, known in El Salvador as salsa inglesa or salsa perins, for some strange reason, extremely popular there. Almost every restaurant provides a bottle of salsa perins on each table. Over 120,000 gallons or 2.2 ounces per person is consumed annually, the highest per capita consumption after England. Legend has it that the British brought the weird sauce to El Salvador while the railroad system was being built. My mom brought that custom here because she will use it on all her cooking all the time. She was so happy for that two-pack, very cheap package that is sold at Costco. Puchica.
Did you know that Monica Lewinsky's father, Bernardo, was born in El Salvador? A la gran puchica.
This, did you know, should be in Ripley's Believe It or Not. Nicknamed La Guerra del Fútbol, aka the Soccer War, also known as the 100-Hour War, was a real war fought between El Salvador and Honduras in 1969, when El Salvador won and qualified for the World Cup.
The war began July 14th of 1969, when the Salvadoran military launched an attack against Honduras. I still remember, they used World War II planes and bombs that didn't explode because they were so old. Finally, the Organization of American States, in other words, the gringos, negotiated a ceasefire. They basically said, okay, kids, go back and sell bananas and coffee. El Salvador's current president is Nayib Bukele, a young, good-looking Palestinian Salvadoran who ran as a populist, but is really an authoritarian that has no patience for gangs. His policies are almost evangelical. El Salvador has the harshest penalties against abortion, and women's rights are in peril. Human rights groups are keeping an eye on this guy. And now some cumbia music from El Salvador.
Y estoy orgulloso de mi linda patria.
Soy salvadoreño,
de esta tierra hermosa que con magia encanta. Ay, no. ¿De qué la bailamos? Con la magistral
Orquesta Premier.
Well, that's it, friends. Thank you for watching. And remember to go back to the theater. San Diego Rep will be offering Mother Road by Octavio Solis. See you next month.